Hello and welcome to an unboxing of The Long Walk. This is not of a quantity of 12. This is a quantity of, well, 2. But it does contain number 68. This, my friends, is the Centipede Press unboxing of The Long Walk by Richard Bachman, a.k.a. Stephen King. One of his Bachman books. For the first time in a standard... Oop, hitting my own camera there. Pardon me. I'll get the dongle out of the way. First time in a standard hardcover publication. And I am excited for it. So this is going to be 2 copies of it. This is the unsigned hardcover and the signed hardcover. Now, this is not signed by Stephen King or Richard Bachman, as I keep beating the ever-living hell out of my camera stand. Sorry, bear with me. It's a big box. And oh, we got a goodie. So, we also have a little piece from Burn Witch Burn, the Merritt story, which I've also unboxed on the channel. Very nice. Now, both of these are sold out, but we've got the slipcased hardcover here, the numbered edition, 68, signed by all of the contributors except for King himself. Because that's not gonna happen. And then the unsigned edition. The unsigned edition should be exactly the same, except it's not gonna have the signature, obviously. It's not gonna have the slipcase. So we're gonna start with the signed edition. We're gonna put the unsigned edition on the side there. Because in your hoarder like me, you gotta buy one of each, right? So the signed edition sold out really quickly. This was limited to 500 copies. And the unsigned was, I think, 1,400 copies. Very excited for this. There's something else in it. Oh. So, what do we got here? Got a little booklet that came with it, Jim. Okay. I didn't realize it came with a little extra booklet. This, like, extra material that didn't get into the novel itself. Thank you for purchasing our book. Oh, just a little thank you from Centipede Press. I know this was a very special one for Jared to publish. It's crazy that he was able to keep the wraps on this. And it was very exciting to see it see the light of day. So that's fantastic. Slipcase kind of follows the cloth binding of the normal slipcase design for Centipede Press. We got a little stamping of some of the walkers going across it. Very, very nice. And we get the book itself. Top edge stain is bound in cloth. It has a double-sided dust jacket. I think it's the same dust jacket on either side. One just has the text on the spine. This is Stephen King, The Long Walk, as they're walking by King's Diner. And then you have the same dust jacket on the flip side without the Stephen King on the spine. It almost looks like it's kind of a glossier. Maybe that's just because of the Mylar dust jacket as well. I don't know. All right, the book itself, bound in cloth with stamping of the walkers going across it. Very, very nice. Now, this is dust jacket and interior artwork is by Jim and Ruth Keegan. But it does have some photographs of Patrick Loehr as well. A new introduction by Bev Vincent. Stephen King writing as Richard Bachman. This was written as his, he was a freshman in college, but wasn't published till years later, when he was publishing under the Richard Bachman name. So there is... Okay, so we do have The Long Walk, and we do have the original covers. Bachman there, the New English Library edition from 1980. Prior to him, some photographs of Patrick Loehr. And we do have, oh, little header illustrations as well. This is the story of Ray Garrity and 99 other walkers who are partaking in the Long Walk, which starts at the border, Canadian border up in Maine, and just continues down Highway 1, U.S. Route 1. Oh, so there are illustrations. Oh my God, there are! There are like little illustrations that are inlaid with the text. That is really cool, really creative. I haven't read all of Bachman's books, but I have read this one. So the Bachman books, you got Rage, you got The Long Walk, Roadwork, The Running Man, then you've got Thinner, and you've got Blaze. I have read The Long Walk, Blaze, and Thinner. I have not read Rage. I've not read Roadwork. I do have a cheap old copy of Bachman Books paperback that I really need to read it someday. But anyways, let's start with The Long Walk because we're 5 minutes in. So as I said, it's about Ray Garrity and 99 other walkers starting up at the Canadian border of Maine, walking down Highway 1, keeping a brisk 4-mile-an-hour pace. If not, if they lag behind or if they stop, they are executed. And it is survival of the fittest. It's who can walk the longest. We're talking no breaks, no bathroom breaks, no change of footwear, just walking. And it is brutal. It is a brutal, brutal read. The winner gets all of their dreams come true. Think of it like, you know, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory from hell. You got the kids getting eliminated one by one, and the winner gets the Chocolate Factory. Well, Ray Garrity, he wants that Chocolate Factory. He wants it real bad. And, you know, they got soldiers following him every move, including the major, who is just there to make sure things keep moving. So, you know, it's kind of a predecessor to the Hunger Games, except instead of killing each other, they're walking till they die. And I gotta say, it's nice to see, I would even call it fully illustrated. I mean, it's smaller illustrations like that. It's but that is pretty illustrated. And it's not like, you know, just a couple little pieces here and there. And we're talking, the Keegans went all out. I mean, sure, a lot of them are little half pages, but you do have full pages within. It is incredible. Very, very well done. This is the second of the Centipede Press titles that Stephen King has had the honor of being released through. First being Salem's Lot, which was much earlier in Centipede Press's lineup. That is a hot commodity. This, of course, is a signature page here, signed by Bev Vincent, Jim and Ruth Keegan, and Patrick Loehr. So 500 signed copies. It's not going to, obviously this one's not signed by Stephen King. Salem's Lot from many years ago was signed by Stephen King and is a very hot commodity. Very, very hot commodity. That was before I knew of Centipede Press. And I'm honestly surprised that Jared from Centipede Press was able to do another one. I've heard, from what I've seen, because I've never held it in my hands, but I have been told that the Salem's Lot is incredible. You can kind of get, even though it wouldn't be the Centipede Press edition, you can get one that features all of the illustrations in a regular trade edition that got published. But the actual signed edition is a hot commodity. But anyways, as I was saying, I'm surprised that he got a second Stephen King book just because for some reason, King wasn't thrilled with the Salem's Lot. He thought it was too bulky, or that's what I've heard, that he had thought it was too bulky. And so I thought he had kind of written off Jared and Centipede Press, which is a shame because Jared does phenomenal work. So this right here is just the regular trade edition, the first trade hardcover edition by itself. This is not signed by anybody, but it's the exact same book. Same contents, same illustrations, same cloth binding. You're just not getting the signature page or the slipcase. You know, you get caught up in the moment, you buy one of each. I probably won't keep both. I'll probably keep the slipcase edition, but, you know, it gives me a chance to reread The Long Walk in a beautiful hardcover edition while keeping the slipcase edition nice and pristine. But my hat's off to you, Jared. That is phenomenal. Thank you very much for matching 68 to match many of my other Centipede titles. I also have the funds in there for Dune Messiah, so when that rolls around in a month or so, we should hopefully get matching 68 on there as well. So this is completely sold out through Centipede Press, both the unsigned and the signed edition. But you can find on the secondary market. I know as people are getting their copies, they are some people are turning around and selling their copies. So you can find it on the secondary market. But what an absolutely beautiful book. If you are new to Centipede Press, they have a very distinct style, which The slipcase definitely has that style here. The book itself, not so much. He likes to use a lot of black cloth, black Japanese cloth. So this one's obviously bound in gray, but it's a stellar quality small press edition that you're going to expect from Centipede Press. And you got to get on the Centipede Press newsletter, or else the titles sell out far too quickly, much like this one did. But anyways, thank you so much, Jared, for the beautiful books. What an absolutely pleasant surprise, and what a hell of a way to kick off 2023. Even though this wasn't technically the first 2023 Centipede Press title, it is one hell of a bang to start with. Thank you guys very much for watching. Please consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see you around next time.